Well, that did not take long. When I did my first Doom Eternal video, I did my best to show you how to reduce the graphics further with the tools available in the base game via the developer console. I followed up with a video on the original Doom 2016, which now has a mod that allows full debug console access for a more detailed control at lights, LODs, and the dynamic resolution scaler, and I hoped something similar will surface for Doom Eternal. Well, I did not have to wait long, and the results are both extremely useful and extremely shocking. But not in a way a lot of people expect, or probably what you wanted if you were familiar with my content already. If not, welcome to the LowSpecGamer. Before starting, I have to give a clear explanation of the tools I will be using. To enable the full range of console commands, I will be using a program that modifies the values stored in memory while the game is running, called Cheat Engine. Cheat Engine has a lot of useful, legit uses, from creating mods like free cameras, which are the basis for entire verticals of YouTube content, all the way through digging in the game files for unused content, like the gun for this game, or all sorts of creative mod making. But as the name implies, some people use it as a game genie sort of device to provide extra health in games and such. This is fine in single player games. As you can imagine, I'm all in for people being able to experiment and modify their games, but this is a big no-no for multiplayer games. Since Doom Eternal has a multiplayer component, I want to make something very clear. I will be focusing only and exclusively on graphical changes, and none of this should ever be tried in the multiplayer mode. You can rely on my previous video for multiplayer purposes, since that is often safe, but do not use Cheat Engine in multiplayer. You have been warned. And if you do, and you get banned or suspended, don't add me. That's on you. Cool? Cool. This amazing console unlock mod was created by Sunbeams. This is a script slash mod that needs to be applied from within Cheat Engine when running the game. This is a simple process. With the game running, you select the Doom Eternal process from the cheat engine and you open the script and you will see in the options down here a toggle to enable the hidden commands. It takes a minute at most and all links are in the description. Once that short process is done, you are ready to rumble, and oh boy is there stuff here to rumble with. There's a pervasive fog in a lot of levels of Doom. It helps a lot with the whole hail vibe. Very easy to get rid of using the R skip fog command. R LOD force if set to 10 can force loading certain low detail versions of some models to save on performance. On the past and some other games, the changes can be quite dramatic, but in Doom Eternal, these changes are very slight and mostly environmental, so you can use this without too much worry. Decals are an interesting one. On the previous video, I showed you how to disable temporary decals like bullet holes. But in reality, the game uses decals in many other places. There's a terrific video by John Linneman of Digital Foundry where he talks to Ed Games about the technology and tools they use to create these games, and there's an entire section about how they use decals and blending features of the engine to create better looking and better performing environments, and you can see which variables the folks at EAT were using to disable those effects. And guess what? With a full console available, you can disable those yourself now. It is impressive just how much they use decals for effect here. I kinda like it. There's also R sky lighting set to 0, which disables some of the light sources. Here we start getting into the territory of changes that are more destructive, even if they increase performance, so at this point you have to customize yourself. For example, there's a hilarious command called G-enable-gore that when set to 0 dramatically reduces the amount of dismemberment in the game, and when set to 2, the game does its best to eliminate all traces of violence, so no pieces fall off enemies, and often the only real way of breaking them apart is using the chainsaw. If you're experiencing severe lag during glory kills, or you just find the violence against the mortally challenging objectionable, this command will help. Then there is R skip lights, which can disable all lights. That was funny. This might be too much, right? Wrong! You can increase the variable R texture LOD bias to gradually reduce the quality of textures lower and lower and lower. Yes! Hello, texture artist. I am the harbinger of your doom! R-skip particles disables the generation of new particles, so existing ones are all now glitched, and all your bullets and enemy attacks are invisible. Worse than that, it's no lights. Using R-skip process 1 to disable all post-processing makes it even harder to watch. Not enough? How about we disable all of the game models? Let's disable all of the game models. Okay, I admit, maybe I went a little bit too far. So let's do something useful again. Turns out with the console unlocked, we get some control over the dynamic resolution scaler. This is a feature that was available for Doom 2016 on game consoles and could be unlocked on PC. When a dev console unlock mod was made, Alex Battaglia from Digital Foundry did an excellent video about it. I now realize that I have mentioned Digital Foundry twice in this video already. I'm probably sad that Gamescom got cancelled and I will not get to hang out with them this year. Okay, last time I promised. Alex's video explains in great detail how the resolution scaler works and creates profiles for it to work on different FPS targets. I then adapted those for 30fps and lower resolutions on a video I did. Doom Eternal has the resolution scaling functionality in the menu, but it cannot target under 60fps. The bad news is that even with the console commands, the game will only take 50% as the lowest allowed resolution, which is not tremendously useful, but at least we can now control the target frame rate and set it to 30fps. The other bad news is that on its current form, the mod does not seem to allow loading these commands from an external file using exec. However, you can copy and paste commands in the dev console, and you can put more than one command per line using a semicolon. So what I have done is gathered the most balanced, low-end settings in one line, and I will leave them in the description. You can customize with the info in this video, copy it on a file somewhere, and after you run the mod, when the game starts, you can paste it on the dev console. I have left you three versions, one with only graphical changes, one with graphical changes and the dynamic resolution scaler set to 30fps, and another with it set to 60fps. Alright, what performance can this allow us? Sadly, while Intel has updated their drivers to the point that the game now boots on Intel HD, I can still not get past a VRAM allocation error on my laptop when it tries to load. I'm still working on any Intel HD setting. I must again return to the $50 dual-core Athlon 3000G with Vega 3 integrated graphics. Using the most extreme version of these changes with no dynamic resolution in a quiet area sees the game jumping dramatically in performance, so I naturally wondered if a 60fps lock was possible. I threw the game into one of the heavier areas, the Super Gore Nest, using all of the commands I have shown you except the ones that break the game, 720p and dynamic resolution target near 60fps. The result isn't quite as I expected, as the resolution does not drop enough to actually maintain a constant close to 60fps average. However, you have to appreciate the fact that this is even possible. I feel like I'm almost playing an entirely different game. God, what an experience! So, two changes. Now I'm going to reduce our texture LOD bias to 2 since the extremely low textures were affecting the UI and the playability in ways that I do not like, and I changed the target of the resolution scaler to 30fps. The result is actually surprisingly good and will probably benefit from a proper 30fps lock. Not bad! I suspect a lot of people might get a lot of use out of this. As I said before, remember that these tools are only for single player use, and any use of cheat engine is not recommended in multiplayer. But if you want to enjoy this campaign no matter what, consider trying this thing out. Now, if you like games like Doom and their design, and happen to be the 10% of my audience that speaks Spanish, I have a quick message for you. Vaya aún, un desarrollador involucrado en juegos como Spec Ops The Line y Blasphemous, y yo hemos empezado un podcast donde hablamos temas desde dos perspectivas, él como desarrollador y yo como youtuber. Se llama Pantalla Partida y subimos episodios semanalmente. Por ejemplo, hace poco hablamos de la controversia de cómo algunos jugadores odian mecánicas o enemigos como el merodeador en Doom, y qué hace un desarrollador ante las críticas de algo que parezca fundamental para el juego, pero sea recibido de forma mixta. Lo lanzamos un poco en secreto, pero de verdad que se está poniendo bastante bueno, así que si te interesa, ¿por qué no pruebas un episodio? Te dejo el enlace en la descripción y pronto lo empiezo a subir a su propio canal de YouTube.